Hello students, this is Sandeep sir here from Vijay Tutorial. So here we are going to discuss in this video some important questions of chemical kinetics. Okay, here one question you see is given: a first order reaction takes 69.3 minutes for 50% completion. How much time will be needed for 80% completion? Okay, so this type of questions they will ask in the exam, board exam. What is given? Okay. T half is given. T half means time required for 50% is how much? 69.3 minutes, sir. Okay, and they're asking, what is the time required for 80% completion? T80% is what? Okay, since we know that T half of a first order reaction is what? T half of a first order reaction is what? 0.693 upon K. Okay. So, or we can write K is equal to 0.693 upon T half. Yes or no? So, if you substitute here, you'll get the value of K, 0.693 upon K, upon T half. T half is how much? 69.3. If you remove this, you'll get 10. If you remove this, okay, you'll get 1000, right? This get cancelled. So, here 1 by 100. 1 by 100 is what? 10 to the power minus 2, second inverse. Okay. Now we get to know the value of K. Now they're asking what is the time required for 80% completion. We also know that T is equal to what? General expression 2.303 upon K log of initial concentration by final concentration. Yes or no? So T for 80% we can write means 2.303 upon K. K is how much? You're getting 10 to the power minus 2. Into log of initial concentration, let it be 100. Okay. 100 or not. By final concentration, 80% is decomposed. So, what is the final concentration? 100 minus 80 of R naught. Okay. So, R naught it cancels. So, substitute the values, you'll get T80%. T80% is equal to what? 2.303. This 10 power minus 2, it goes up, become 10 power plus 2. Into log of 10 upon 20, right? Sorry, 100 minus 80 is what? 20. So this one, okay, log 5. Log 5 value you can take a 0.7. Okay, roughly rough value of 0.7. Okay, so we can write further T 80% is equal to 2.303 upon, okay, into 10 power 2. Log 5 is what? 0.7. If you solve this, see how much you're getting. Okay, if you multiply 2.303 into 100, become what? 230. Okay. 0.3. Yes or no? Into 0.7, you do multiply by 7. Okay, 0.7, you'll get 21. Balance is to 7 into 0, 0 plus 2. Okay. 73 21 balance is to 72 21 plus 2 23. Wait, I think we have done some mistakes, sir. So when you multiply here, okay, you will get 73 21. Okay, then sorry, 73 21. Okay, balance is 2, 7 into 0, 0 plus 2. 73 is 21, balance is 2. Okay, 72 is 14 plus 2, 16. Okay, so decimal will come here. 161.2. Okay, 161.2 per minute. Okay, am I clear? Because in the first, actually here time was given in minute, right? So here it will, rate constant will be in what? Minutes only. Minute inverse here. It will not be in second inverse. It will be in minute inverse. Because here you see, okay, the time is given in minutes. Okay, when the time is given in minutes, rate constant will be in minute inverse. Okay, so in the next, if you just, we are converting to 80%, we are getting in minute only answers. Okay, next important concept, sir, you should understand, is a temperature dependence of a rate of a reactions. Okay, so we are going to discuss the temperature dependence. Okay, temperature dependence of a rate of a reaction. See here, what happens actually, for every 10 degree rise in temperature, the rate of a reaction becomes double. But only 16% collision increases. It can be explained by Arrhenius equation, we will deal in the next sections. Okay, so here few terms are there, you should know. Okay, first term is what? Temperature coefficient. Okay, what is temperature coefficient? Temperature coefficient is a ratio of rate constant of a reaction at two temperature, okay, differing by 10 degree. So temperature selected are generally 298 Kelvin and 308 Kelvin. So here we can write temperature coefficient is equal to what? Rate constant is equal to rate constant at T plus 10 degree divided by rate constant at T divided by rate constant at T. At T instances. Okay. So what happens? Important point is here, generally for most reactions, the temperature coefficient lies between 2 and 3. So they may ask you numericals based on this. Next, what is collision frequency? You can see here, what is collision frequency? It is defined as the total number of collisions per unit volume per unit time. Okay. Next, what is effective collision? The collision which leads to the formation of product molecules are called as effective collisions. Okay, one relation you have to understand. What do you mean? Rate of a reaction is equal to F into Z. Where F is what? Fraction of collision, and Z is what? Collision frequency. Okay. Next important concept, what is threshold energy? The minimum energy that the reacting molecules must possess in order to undergo effective collisions to form the product is called as what? Threshold frequency. Next, activated complex or transition state. You can see activated complex is the highest energy unstable intermediate between the reactant and the product and gets decomposed immediately, having very short life, okay, to give the product. In this state, the bond of the reactants are not completely broken, while the bonds of the products are not completely formed. You can see this graph. This is the reaction coordinate versus energy. You can see, okay. So energy of reactant is here. So once it attains the activation energy, okay, so it will form what? Activated complex. Then only the reactant molecules will collide and form the product. So this is graph is very important. Okay, reaction coordinates versus energy. Now what is activated energy? Activation energy, you see here, as I told you, the additional amount of energy required by the reactant so that the energy becomes equal to that of the threshold value is known as activation energy. See, for any reaction to take place, okay, some energy is required. That energy is called as what? Activation energy. Okay, so if that energy is not provided, then reaction will not occur only. Okay, so you can see here, when the reactant is at this energy, if you provided activation energy, so then only it formed the activated complex. Okay, so activated activation energy is equal to what? ET minus ER. Okay, what is ET? It is the activation, sorry, it is actually threshold energy. It is what? Threshold energy. Okay, by mistakes it is written. Okay, it is what? Threshold energy. Okay, whereas ER is what? Average energy produced by the reacting molecules. Okay, so lower the activation energy, faster is the reaction. Okay, so if any reaction is there, if it needs less energy, okay, less activation energy means it will occur faster. Am I clear? So different reactions have different rates because of their activation energies are different. Okay, all reactions will not occur at the same rate because of their different difference in activation energy. Am I clear? And larger is value. Okay. Means if the larger the value of E naught, a smaller value of the rate constant, and greater is the effect of given temperature rise on. Okay. Next, you should understand is the Arrhenius equation. Okay. Arrhenius equation. Okay. So Arrhenius equation is a mathematical expression to give the quantitative relationship between the rate constant and the temperature, and the expression is like this. You see, try to understand. K is equal to A into e to the power minus EA by RT. Okay. K is a rate constant. A is called as pre-exponential factor. Okay. A frequency factor. Okay. Or EA is activation energy. R is a rate gas constant. E is the temperature. If you apply log both side. Okay. Apply natural log. Okay. Both side. So what we can write, ln K is equal to ln A into e to the power minus EA by RT. Okay. So log of M into N, you can apply log of M plus N. So what finally we write, ln K is equal to ln A plus ln E to the power minus EA by RT. So ln E is, or what we can write, log of E is what? 1. So what we can write, minus EA by RT. Okay. ln e is what? 1. Okay, so finally we are getting, here I have applied log of e to the power minus a by rt, log of m to the power n log m, right? So we can write ln k is equal to ln a minus a by rt. Okay, so this is the expression. If you want to convert this natural log to the base 10, you have to multiply by 2.303. okay, so multiply by 2.303, you get a log to the base 10, log of k to the base 10 is equal to log of a to the base 10 minus 2.303 upon rt. This expression is very, very important. Okay, so here you can, they may ask you the graph also between log of k and 1 by t. Okay, so you can rearrange and write here. You can write here, log of k to the base 10 is equal to minus 2.303 by rt plus log of a to the base 10. So this is a graph of y is equal to mx plus c. Okay, x is what? 1 by t actually. Okay, so y is what? Log of k to the base 10. Okay, and slope is what? Minus 2.303 upon r. X is what? 1 by t, and slope is what? Log of a to the base 10. Okay, so you should understand this graph. Y plus mx plus c graph is this. So the slope is negative, right? So here, this is a graph given here. If you want to plot the graph, you can see. Okay, 1 by t along the x-axis and log of k along the y-axis. Slope is what? Minus EA by 2.303 R. And this is what? Log of A to the base 10. Log of A to the base 10. Okay. So this graph. So you can see here it is written only. A is what? Frequency or Arrhenius factor. It is also called as pre-exponential factor. R is a gas constant. EA is the activation energy. So if you just take the temperature, two different temperature, when the temperature is T1, okay, when the temperature is T1, okay, rate constant is R1. When the temperature changes to T2, rate constant changes to R2. Okay, and there is a relationship. Okay, if R2 and R1 are the rate constant at temperature T2 and T1, then log of K2 by K1. Okay, rate constant, you should take a K1, K2. Okay, when the temperature is T1, rate constant is K1. When the temperature changes to T2, rate constant changes to K2. So this is the relation you should understand. Log of K1 by K2 is equal to A by 2.303 R, T2 minus T1 by T1 into T2. Okay. So